This is an introduction to a series on narcissistic patterns of behavior you should be concerned about. I am reading from an article that was shared, written by Joanna Ashmun at halcyon.com. She describes beautifully the subtle behavior patterns that are initially very hard to spot, but are telltale red flags that you are dealing with a classic narcissist. Let's begin. Contradiction. The most telling thing that narcissists do is to contradict themselves. They will do this virtually in the same sentence without even stopping to take a breath. It can be as trivial as about what they want for lunch, or it can be as serious about whether or not they love you. When you ask them which one they mean, they'll deny ever saying the first, though it may literally have been only seconds since they said it. Really, how could you think they'd ever say that? You need to have your head examined. They will contradict facts. They will lie to you about things you did together. They will misquote you to yourself. If you disagree with them, they'll say you're lying, making stuff up, or that you're crazy. At this point, if you panic and want to talk to anyone who will listen about what is going on, this would be a healthy reaction. It's a reality check. Because you're confused by the narcissist's contrariness, you will turn to the other person to help you keep your bearings. You know something is seriously wrong, and now you worry that it might be you. If you're feeling and thinking these things, these are all signs that you are not the narcissist. Note, normal people can behave irrationally under emotional stress. They can be confused, deny things they know, get sort of paranoid, and want to be babied when they're in pain. But normal people recover pretty much within an hour or two or a day or two. With normal people, your expressions of love and concern for their welfare will be taken to heart. They will be stabilized by your emotional and moral support. Not so with narcissists. The surest way I know of to get a crushing blow to your heart is to tell a narcissist that you love him or her. They will respond with a nasty power move, such as telling you to do things entirely their way or else be banished from them forever. You may get into disputes with narcissists over their casual dishonesty and cruelty to other people. Trying to reform narcissists by reasoning with them or by appealing to their better nature is about as effective as spitting in the ocean. What you see is what you get. They have no better nature. The fundamental problem here is that narcissists lack empathy. Lacking empathy is a profound disturbance to the narcissist's thinking, cognition, and feeling affectivity. Even very intelligent narcissists cannot reason well. One I've worked with closely does something I characterize as analysis by egg beater. They don't understand the meaning of what people say, and they don't grasp the meaning of the written word either. Because so much of meaning of anything we say depends on context and affect, narcissists, lacking empathy and thus lacking both context and affect, hear only words. Discussions with narcissists can be really weird and disconcerting. They seem to think that using some of the same words means that they are following a line of conversation or reasoning. Thus, they will go off on tangents and irrelevancies, apparently in the blithe delusion that they understand what others are talking about. And frankly, they don't hear all the words either. They can pay attention only to conversations that have them in it. This is not merely a bad habit, it's a cognitive deficiency. Narcissists pay attention only to themselves and the stuff that affects them personally. However, since they don't know what other people are doing, narcissists can't judge what will affect them personally and seem to never learn that when they cause trouble, they will get trouble back. They won't take other people's feelings into consideration, and so they overlook the fact that other people will react with feeling when abused or exploited, and that most people get really pissed off by being lied to or lied about. I would like to add that this also creates a cognitive dissonance within you if you're subjected to a narcissist on a regular basis and don't know what you're dealing with. You will feel a threat of anxiety when having to talk to this person because your mind is always trying to process two competing ideas. Coming up, narcissists lack a mature conscience.